Welcome to Video Animation Beginner's Class with Seclemento. So, we continue with our 2D video animation with Animes Animation Maker. Our topic for this class is adding effects on objects. So, we are into our animes and I'll click on new empty project to open the working environment. This is the working environment on Animes Animation Maker. I already explained the interface and in the last class I showed how to insert text to add text into the working environment. In our last class we talked about adding characters into our working environment, but in this class we are going to look on how we can add effect to our objects. Objects includes your characters, your images, SVGs, tag, callout, etc. So those are your objects. So how do you add an effect to this your objects? That's what I'm going to show you. So let's quickly go into the right hand panel of our working environment and let's add a text. Remember, a text is also an object. Let's add 2D video animation. Okay, let's increase the length and bring it to the center. So that's it. When we click on it, we have highlighted it. Now it's for us to add effect. Now we have three types of effect. We have the entrance effect, modify effect, and the exit effect. So those are the three types of effect that we have on animes. Now look at this text that I've highlighted. It's showing the entrance effect, which is zooming down, and the exit effect, which is always displaying. Remember, you can change it if you want to. But if I want to add the modify effect, I will click on this rhombus symbol here. Once I click on it, you see the size reduces. This is where to add the modify effect in the middle of. You add the modify effects in between the entrance and the exit effect. Now, you can also highlight on this, then you right click on it, and you're going to see modify entrance effect. That's the one in the middle. Then add emphasis, modify entrance effect. That's the zooming, the one coming in front. There's the first one. Add emphasis effect. That's the second one, and modify exit effect. So that's it. You can also see that this text is called an object. That is, they say delete object, locked object is called an object. So if you want to modify the entrance effect, you see it's already on zooming down. But you can change it to whatever you want to change it. Let's play it and see what will appear. See, it zooms it down and always display. But we want to add a modify effect. Let's click on it and see. Let's use this and give the color to be blue. Borderlines. Remember, we have so many modify effects we have. But let's use borderline for now and click OK. This is the movement direction. We want it clockwise or counterclockwise. You can increase the thickness to whatever thickness that you want, or you can still reduce it if you want to reduce it by clicking on this up button and down button. Let's click OK and you can play it and see. Now you can see the line that is playing here. From here you can increase it. Okay, let's increase it to around 6 seconds. You can also drag it to this and let's play it and see. Zooms in down, you see. Once you drag it, you have increased the duration of the modify effect. Now let's reduce it and add another. You can reduce it and add another effect by clicking on this. Let the color change from left to right and click OK. Let's increase this and play it. Let's play it. You can also insert another modify effect by clicking on this icon here. Once you click on it, it will carry us this. Let's use something like bounce 3 times and click OK. Once we can increase the size, play it and see. You see it's going to bounce. That's on that modify effect that you can insert it. You can also insert another one, like, let me see, let's go and look for another modify effect and let's use 360 rotation for it. You can put the direction clockwise or anti-clockwise. In the number of rotation, you can increase it to 3 or whatever amount that you want to increase. Then we can, let me do it like this and increase the bounce play it and see. Once you play it, you see it rotates. So that's how you can insert your modifier effect. You can also go to the entrance effect and change it to whatever you want it to change it. You can do something like letter images and click OK. This one, you can do it as random for it to start from center or whatever you want. But let's put a center to edge and click OK. See, it emerges from the center. Also, this exit effect, you can remove it from this and also change it to corona slide out. From left to right, you can change it there or whatever you want to do. Let's play it from the start and click OK. Let's play it and see what will happen. Rotate and slides out. For example, if it's only a text that is available on a particular canvas, it's advisable you keep it at always display, but if there are so many, you can click none. But if you click none, you see that once it gets to this, it will disappear without any animations. You won't see it again because of this none. But we can still change it to always display. So also we can also insert another object, like let's insert another object like an image. Let's add a local image from our desktop and use this location symbol, and let's reduce the size and keep it here, keep it under the video animation. Let's carry it to around 6 seconds and play it. You see it pulls down. When you look at the entrance effect for the image, is pulling down. You can also change it to whatever you want to change. And let's add something there. Let's add dazzle light for it to dazzle as a modifier effect. Let's just add one only. Let's add the dazzle lights, increase it. Let's click OK. You see the dazzle light is rotating around the image. Also, we can also insert a shape by clicking shape here. Okay, let's go to circle and look for a better shape. Let's insert this shape here. Now you can see for this circle, we can change, replace it animations for the entrance effect as, let me say, real expand for this, and let's carry it to the end. They always display the exit effect, and let's add a modify effect. You can add it, you cannot add it, but it depends on what you are creating. Not that you just stay and just be adding, you have to look at what you're creating to see if it really matches it what you want to create. Now there is this magnifier that you can also use. Let's use this one for now, and let's increase the duration to the end. Let's play it. Now it expands and you see the duration. The magnifier is magnifying object. Is mostly the magnifier mostly used in text when you're trying to search. So that's the end of our class today. We've talked on adding effects to our object. I talked on the different types of object. That objects includes your text, your SVGs, your images, your shapes, and so on. And I give you the three types of effects that can be added to your object. That's the entrance effect, the modify effect, and the exit effect. You can add only one entrance effect, one, and also one exit effect, but you can add unlimited modify effect depending on the duration of your video. So that's the end of our video. In our next class, I'll be teaching on how to render and export your created videos. You know, after creating your videos, you have to download it and share it to different platforms, to your friends and your family, and also to your clients. So see you in the next video. Goodbye.